what this law, SB 1300, has done, it has set out some decrees, basically making it a lot harder for employers to get a case dismissed before trial through a motion for summary judgment. It makes it a lot easier for employees to prove these types of claims, sexual harassment types of claims. So my first bullet point there about the liability is expanded for employers to cover non-employee harassment based on other forms of harassment other than sexual harassment. So this is other harassment based on things such as age, race, etc. And the employer's liable for this harassment, other types of forms of harassment, if the employer knew or should have known of the conduct and didn't take any steps to stop it. The law also prohibits an employer in exchange for a raise or bonus or as a condition of continued employment to require the employee to sign a release of claim or any of the rights on their FEHA or any or requiring an employee to sign any kind of non-disparagement agreement or other document that denies the employee the right to disclose information about unlawful acts in the workplace. And that's including but not limited to sexual harassment. So again, employers need to be careful about any kind of severance agreements or contracts with employees about prohibiting what they can and cannot disclose about the workplace when they're entering into those agreements. Now, the last bullet point on this slide, I wanted to make this clear, though, that the agreements can include a release of claims if the agreement is for a negotiated settlement agreement. And under the law, negotiated means that the agreement is voluntary, deliberate, and informed, and the person provides consideration of value to the employee, and that the employee is given notice and an opportunity to retain an attorney or is represented by an attorney. And so if it's negotiated, then employers can put these releases in the settlement agreements or other types of agreements like severance agreements.